Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. Well, here we are today in Cave City, Kentucky. That's right, and I'm taking you right along with me. We're here at the first annual Shop Truck Gathering, and behind me we have this awesome Willys with a blower, and there is a lot of trucks here to check out. And if you know me, I've got that van that's basically a shop truck, so I'm here to get a little inspiration. Follow me along as I check out some of these awesome vehicles that are here in beautiful Kentucky, and it's a nice day, not too much rain, and the temperatures are a little bit low, so I can appreciate that. Tell me in the comment section below what truck you like the best out of all these that I'm going to show you. So stay tuned. I've got more coming from the RV Bandwagon right about now. Check this out.
Today we've got an excellent show for you, starting with truck number one. Isn't that right, Billy?
Most excellent, dude. This sounds like me in high school, like Woody with the scoop.
I believe that's a Willys with a blower, Billy.
Dude, you better be careful. This is a PG show.
Alrighty then, Billy. Moving on to truck number two. This one looks pretty awesome, although kind of a work in progress like my van.
Yeah, dude, that van of yours looks like it needs a lot of work.
Okay then, this show's not about my van, it's about these awesome trucks. And moving on to truck number three, check this one out.
Yeah, Ralphie's lamp repair, man, I get it. It's from that Toy Story movie.
Be careful, you'll shoot your eye out. It's actually from the Christmas Story movie. Moving on to truck number four, this GMC is slammed to the ground and it's looking pretty sharp.
Like, dude, that thing's as low as you can go. He's gonna be dragging his mufflers for sure.
I believe this GMC is set up with some switches. He's gonna be throwing some hydraulics to get that thing up off the ground.
Yeah, we're moving on to truck number five, one of my favorites, cause it's got a cycle in the back, Jack.
Yeah, this old Chevy and its passenger have a few rough spots, but they're shiny where it counts, that's for sure. We got another old Chevy here, and this one's pretty shiny all the way around.
Yeah, dude, that's like my granddad's old truck. It was beautiful before I took it and drove it through the orchard. At least that's what I called it.
Moving on to truck number seven, the little Red Express. This little Dodge is pretty dang cool. And now we're on to truck number eight, which might be a little bit newer than is expected to be seen in this show.
Yeah, dude, I was like expecting to see all old, decrepit trucks.
Oh, you mean like this old Chevy work truck?
There you go.
This old rig looks like it came fresh from a barn.
Dude, nobody should leave kids unattended in a hot vehicle.
Speaking of hot vehicles, we've got this truck number 10. It's looking pretty dang hot, if you ask me.
Dude, look at the hand-painted sign work on this old truck.
Yeah, and Rough and Rusty describes this vehicle to a T.
Yeah, and then they had to go and militarize it, dude. That ain't cool.
Maybe not, but pinstripes are cool, and I think you're gonna like truck number 12.
Like, dude, it looks so awesome with the white walls and the flat black matte finish, dude.
Yeah, the Haunches Hot Rods truck looks awesome. Moving on to another Chevrolet, we're at lucky number 13.
Whoa, dude, that's like a terrifying number.
Terrifying possibly, but awesome for sure. We've made it to number 14, and this one's a little rusty around the edges, but it's sounding good.
Dude, that's like so right. It like so reminds me of you.
That's pretty funny, Billy, but why don't you get the truck out of here?
Like, good one, dude. Touché. You got shop truck jokes.
Okay, Billy, enough with the sad jokes. We're gonna go ahead and move on while these trucks head out. Now, truck number 15 is a real beauty and has so much detail put into it, I don't even know if I can consider this a shop truck.
Yeah, that truck looks like it's made for hauling butt, not parts.
Now, if you need to haul something greasy and nasty around, number 16 is the truck you want.
Dude, that's funny. Sounds like you'd fit right in that truck.
And you'd be the slime in the back. Number 17 is another fancy Chevrolet.
Yeah, this shop truck's like one of them big four-wheel drives. They never take off onto the dirt.
Yeah, this one's got a lot of truck going for it, but very little shop. Now, if you want a fat lot of truck, number 18's got a lot of truck and a lot of shop.
Like, totally, dude. This looks like it got drove around the farm a whole lot.
Yeah, a lot of guys would pay a lot of money to get a patina paint job like this one, but this one is all natural. Now we're talking. Number 19 is one of my favorite rigs ever, Chevy Panel Wagon.
Oh, dude, that is so awesome. Do you know the kind of parties we could have in the back?
I always thought it'd be a great rig for hauling my drums. And number 20 is another awesome panel wagon, but far from a shop truck.
Oh, most definitely. This costs more than my whole college education.
Come on, Billy. Did you actually go to college?
Well, I don't actually remember. Dude, I think it was like maybe one of them online free classes, you know? You sign up to learn Spanish and then you buy all these books.
Moving right along to truck number 21, this is a beautiful truck.
Dude, was that like Bob's Big Boy? Cause I'm like really hungry. I could go for a hamburger.
Anyway, moving on to truck number 22, Sonny's Speed Shop.
No, I mean it for sure, dude. Like, my stomach's growling.
Okay, Billy, we'll get you a hamburger, but it's going to be after we talk about some of these trucks.
Now, to me, this one lays out all the guidelines for a classic shop truck. Got your hand-painted logo, you got your patina, you got your classic styling, not to mention it's a rare brand with an awesome hood ornament.
Like, dude, this is a really big show, and like, my stomach is making some gnarly noises right now.
Just hang on a little longer, we're at 23, we've got a classic International Harvester. Check this one out.
Dude, did that say like, eat more possum? Like, I am so hungry right now, I could eat a possum.
In my opinion, this is really what a classic shop truck should look like.
Like, dude, in my opinion, that whole eat more possum thing is making me hungry.
Hey, what's that on the hood? Is that a chicken?
It is a big show, but we've made it to truck number 24, this Ridgetop Auto Truck. It's looking pretty
sweet.
Dude,
this looks excellent with the classic paint and those giant tires tucked up underneath the wheel wells.
Number 25 on the list is this giant Sinclair Ford tow truck.
Oh yeah, like, dude, this truck is some serious heavy metal. This thing totally looks like Mater woke up after a Metallica concert with a bad headache.
It even looks like the tow rig and the hitch on this thing still actually work.
We've made it to number 26 and these trucks just keep getting bigger and badder.
Like, dude, did you see the rims on that thing? They're like some kind of torture device.
I think you may be right. In fact, the whole rig kind of looks like it's made to terrorize the community.
Wow, man. Are you seeing what I'm seeing, or am I having a flashback?
Nope, this is number 27. Same rims, different truck.
Now we'll move on to number 28.
Like, dude, like, let me guess, it's that Chevrolet. I don't know the name. Is it
No, it's not Sanford and Son. It's a Ford equipment truck.
Dude, are like any of these tents food vendors? Because if not, we have to go back to that little big boy's truck.
Nope, haven't seen any food vendors yet, but this dog is awesome, and you gotta have an awesome dog when you have all these awesome trucks. We're now at number 29, and this truck's hitting rock bottom. This old Chevy features an awesome rock bottom tavern logo and some cool paintwork.
Like, dude, did you say tavern? Oh man, this truck show just keeps getting better. Check it out, it says they got the coldest beers in the bottoms. Dude, I am so in.
Now we're gonna get a little crazy with number 30 and go topless.
You just said topless, dude. This show is awesome!
Calm down, Billy. I was talking about the truck being a convertible. This Chevy Sierra also features some cool graphics on the back and a lot more.
We're now at number 31, and this shop truck is the epitome of shop truck.
Dude, this truck is so speaking to me. No, that's my stomach. I wish we were at a food truck gathering.
Number 32 is an old-time farm truck that has obviously been through some restoration.
Hey, dude! I think that's what that truck used to haul.
Number 33 is an old Ford Rat Rod repair truck.
Dude, it looks like that thing's leaking oil. Somebody needs to call a repair truck to come out and fix the repair truck.
We have made it to number 34, which happens to be one of my favorite trucks, and it's a classic old Ford.
Dude, there's nothing old about this classic Ford. This thing's been rebuilt from the ground up, man.
It sure has been, and it's been built right, I've got to tell you. I've done a few trucks on my own, and this one is done to the hilt. It looks like we've got a few more trucks to see and a short time to do it, so let's cruise on down and see what we've missed. I've reached number 35, and I think it's a great time to ask a truck owner to say a few words.
In action. Hey guys, Brian Jones, Bowling Green, Kentucky, Hot Rod Hideout. You guys come check out our Facebook page here in Bowling Green, Kentucky, 1500 Louisville Road. We have all kinds of events throughout the year. Next thing, we have Tri-Fives, LS Fest. We have a lot of events year over year, so come check us out.
Like, dude, that guy and his family were so cool. I'm gonna go check out HotRodHideout.com right now. And like, dude, their Harris Garage shop truck is like beyond sick.
Speaking of sick, this is number 36. It's a fully restored satin black Chevy that's sure to turn your head.
Dude, I believe that's my stomach turning.
Can you believe we made it to number 37 and we've only got just a few more?
Dude, that truck is gorgeous, but show me the possum.
This is number 38, a cool little Chevy Stepside 2-for-1.
Wow, dude, they've militarized number 39. All these politicians want is war, man. Where's the love?
Relax, Billy. It's only a car show. You can save all that serious stuff for when you turn off the YouTube. We finally made it to number 40, and we've got this beautiful blue Johnson's Garage truck.
I don't want blues. I want love, man.
Hey, remember that big giant four-wheel drive truck that I was talking about and never touched the dirt? There it goes. We're now at the number 41 truck, which is the Midnight Auto Parts truck. And remember, if you're missing something from your garage, you might check these guys out. Stolen parts since 1941. We've got just a couple more, starting with 42, the Orange Gulf truck.
Like, dude, did you just say orange? Come on, man, you're killing me.
Well, it's not the fruit, but it is pretty tasty. And finally, number 43, the Volad Rod Shop truck. Make sure you leave a comment down below and let us know what your favorite truck was. Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed that awesome show. The trucks are totally in your face cool. That's all I got to say. And I did get inspired for the van just a little bit. I noticed a lot of hand-painted old school shop signs on the side of the trucks. And so maybe I'll dabble in that a little bit. I think I could do that pretty good. Anyways, we've got more coming at you from the RV Bandwagon right about now. Make sure you stay tuned. Make sure you subscribe. It's getting loud out here. The hot rods are getting rolling, and so are we. You guys, I got more coming at you just about now. Check this out.
Excellent, dude. Finally, we'll get to go into the awesome bandwagon, man, have us some grimace proportions. Dude, I really do like what you have done with the place. Can I shack up here for a while, dude?
Well, you know, Billy, I don't think that's going to work out so well. You know, we're going to be traveling here pretty soon. But you know, you can do what I did and build one yourself. It's awesome.